I'm sewing some Franken-paper. Hey, Christine, how are you? Good, good. I'm well too. Keeping busy, staying busy. You're making some dolls? I am working on Franken-paper. No, this is Franken-paper. I have a custom journal order. So this is for that. So this journal has eight Franken papers, and let me tell you, it has not been easy. Look at you. Go ahead on. I need to clean mine. But I swear I feel like cleaning a craft room is like a never ending thing. So Franken-paper is very similar to like a collage or like a master board, except it's not backed with anything. So it's just different scraps and bits of paper that's glued together, and then I sew it. You don't have to sew it, but I sew it because I like the way it looks. But both sides, you see, have that collage look on it. Thank you, Aries. And so these are meant to be a signature, a page in your signatures for your books. so it'll be folded. You're very welcome. Oh, Mary, that stink. I'm sorry. Thank you, Susan. Thank you. I like doing Franken-paper, but it's a lot of work. Like this one, for example, it had, there's 8 for this one order that I have. And I try, because it's going in a specific book, a specific insert journal of mine, I kind of wanted to make sure I stuck to the theme, you know, like with the color scheme and everything. So, it was difficult for me to do, kind of so many of the same color scheme and things. But I'm working it out now, I guess. Yes, this is where I got this information, like this inspiration from Nick the Booksmith. I love Nick the Booksmith. Thank you, Wanda. Well, you can use big paper, like you can use bigger. Hold on. So this one here, right? It's 2 pieces of book pages, some coffee dyed paper, and then some tracing paper that I glued together. So, like, you know, there are different ways. Yes, Nick the Booksmith is amazing. She's, like, so creative. I did a live event where I was making this, and I said her name so many times. Because, you know, if I get an idea from somebody, then I'm letting people know where I got the idea from. But, yeah, this is definitely based on Nick the Booksmith. She's amazing. She's on, I'm going to pin the comment. That's her name, N-I-K, the Booksmith. She's on YouTube. If you guys want amazing ideas, definitely go watch her. Thank you, Susan. Hey, Eric. So, you know, you can use medium size. You can use larger size. I do have some where I use smaller pieces. And some of these take up, like, especially if you go smaller, I'm making, like, almost an 8.5 by 11 piece of paper out of scraps, so it can take a hot little minute. We have this one. So yeah, I love stitching on my paper. I think I've been stitching on my paper for quite some time now. It's like, I love it. This is, here we go. Just get this out of the way real quick. This is a Halloween journal that I just did. This is available for purchase. It is on my coffee shop. My coffee shop is linked in my bio on my link tree. So you got a nice little tassel there. She's not decorated. She's not decorated in a typical sense. I did add some charms to her. And every single page in here has stitching on it. Every single page. That's, you know, that's a kind of staple in how I create my books. Almost all of my books have stitching incorporated. Thank you, Crazy Rachel. So yeah, so me and my sewing machine were tight. I probably spend more time with my sewing machine than my boyfriend, so. Thank you for the dino. I pick dinos because they remind me of my kid. He loves dinos. He'll run around the house and be like, rawr. So yeah, you can do really, really fun stuff with your sewing machine. You just can't be scared. Cucubanos. Oh no, I lost my thread. How's everyone doing tonight? It's technically it's Wednesday morning, but you know. Did everyone have a good Tuesday? When I'm using my sewing machine, I use regular thread. I use the needle that comes with it. This is a Brother CS6000i. The needle is the needle that I came with 4 years ago. The only thing that I would say is if you're first starting to do this, just maybe take your time. That's probably the best tip that I can give you. Take your time doing it. Go slow. Like, I have my... So, this is the speeds. This is slow. This is medium. And this is fast. I've been on fast for a hot little minute. So, take your time. And be creative. Thank you for the share. I appreciate that. I'm going to be doing this for a while, guys, so if you're noise sensitive, definitely turn down your volume. Oh man, look at that, we're already at 100.5k likes. I appreciate that. If you guys just want to sit there and tap, tap, tap while I'm doing this, thank you. I am working on some custom Franken-paper. I definitely think the stitching does make it more Frankenstein-y, right? Because you think Frankenstein, you know, he's all stitched up and put together, you know, different pieces with stitches. So you don't have to do the stitching, but I definitely think it adds to it. So on this one, I got a little bit fun. And I use lots of zigzag and straight stitches. Just to... Once again, it gets folded. So this will be used as a signature in a book. So it will be folded. So, you know, you're not going to see all of it as one. So, everyone that's here, do you guys know what a junk journal is? We may have some new people in here that have no idea what a signature is. Give me a sign. Here, thank you. That's fun. Look at that. Alright, that's cool. I need to do that somewhere else. So one of the key things to remember if you're doing this, is that you're seeing the page from the front and the back, right? So when you're designing it, you kind of have to pay attention to the front and the back. Dang it. My bobbin popped. Well, my bobbin finished. So, baby. Love me, say that you love me, say you hate me, say that you need me. Don't anything but you. If for whatever reason you mess up on something like this, okay, that's so exciting. It's definitely lots of fun. I don't even have like a background in sewing. I started sewing masks in 2020. That's the reason I bought the sewing machine. And this sewing machine has literally sewn only masks and paper. What are you doing? C. Williams, what am I doing? I am creating decorative paper for a junk journal. Well, a journal. The only thing you have to learn is have fun and be creative. And that's it. So I have a video on my page, so let me go ahead and hop this off real quick so you guys can get an idea of what I'm doing. And if you guys could, you know, maybe hop on over and take a look at some things, that would be cool. So this is similar to what I'm doing now. So you see, those are my Franken-papers there. Just a different color because it's a different theme. It's a different book. Yeah, there you go. You get an idea of what it is. Oh, if you've done scrapbooking, you're gonna do fine. Junk journaling, all it is a spin-off of scrapbooking. So you see, I had to replace my bobbin, but now I have these holes in my paper. I'm not even going to worry about that, because that just adds an extra texture. As a matter of fact, I might just add some holes in other spots, too. But I am going to... Way back when... I did scrapbooking, like when I was like a teen. I do, for this paper, I do zigzag and straight stitch a lot because there's already a lot going on. I don't really like doing a lot of the decorative. Stitches, I have 59 stitches on mine, but for this, just like I said, because it's so much already going on, I tend to stick to zigzag and straight. Thank you. It's definitely an art form all on its own. Yep, just the regular needle. I don't think I bought any extra needles since I bought this machine. So I like to flip from the front and the back to take a look at things. Like I said, because both of these sides are going to be seen. Good night. Thank you so much for being here, Care. Oops. I don't need to do that, but it's okay. feel like this one's gonna have a lot of sewing. MV. This is the... CS6000i. Yes, it is an automated... Well, I mean... kind of automated threader. You still have to do it yourself, but yeah. It has this little hook here that you pull the thread through and you let it go and it goes into the needle. Very welcome. I like it. It's very, I think it's very beginner friendly. I tell everyone that you can pretty much use it straight out of the box. Thank you for the follow. I appreciate that. Thank you for the follow. If you're following me during my live, I will follow you back once I'm done. Unless you're a scammer. If you look like you're a scammer. If you look like you're not a real person. Sorry, not sorry. So, Lionel Richie started following me the other night. It's like, yeah, no. Yeah, that's not. You really think I'm gonna think you're real? No, you're, nope, you're probably not real. You're probably not Lionel Richie. Don't be intimidated. What's the worst that's gonna happen? Someone tells you they don't like it? They're just somebody on the internet. They don't matter. Do it. Oh, how long have you been a sewer for? Look, I don't sew. So I'm not. I don't sew. But I sew paper. I make books. And to make the books, I need paper. And I don't like boring paper. So I make my own paper. Some of my most popular videos are on my sewing machine, and people, you know, they have all the questions. What kind of machine is it? Is it easy to use? Is it this? Is it that? Did it, you know, like how do you use it? And you know, how do I sew this? And so if you do like tutorial based, videos, you'd probably get a pretty cool following. I wish I could take the credit for it, but this is not an original idea. I watch 5 million YouTubers. Not all 5 million do this. No, they don't. But there are quite a few who do this, so. Wendy doll, hello. Hang out the pastor's side, the best friend. Try to hide me. I have, so many of these pages to do. So I have 8 of them. I'm on number 3 now. I'm going to try to finish them before bed. Oh, yes. I'm talking to you. I think, you know what, I kind of like that. I like the simplicity of that one. So you can have as little or as much sewing as you want. So I think what I might get a little bit fun with this one since no sleep. Maria, thank you for the follow. I slept. I did get some sleep this afternoon. But I need to get this done and over with. Like, I need to get this order out. It's been a little while, so I need to get it out. Thank you, MV. I appreciate you being here. Have a good night. I look forward to seeing some of your videos. And I gave you all my just one time to you. What color is my logo? I don't know. I don't really have a logo. You know that, Wendy? I just got my name. Yeah, like, I've thought about coming up with a logo before, but I don't know. They all just seem so, like, I don't know, not what I want. So, like, generic, honestly. Halfway done. Halfway done. If you're gonna be like me and put your hand under here, just be careful. Because you can get caught up real quick and it hurts. For now, no. Not, I just got here, really. But, I was gonna be in here working on this anyway. This was, like, the goal to finish all, like, all of this tonight. So, I was like, I may as well hop on live while I'm doing it. I have to fold it in half to make sure I like it, and then I can say it's done. I like this. It's cute. My baby. Miss Goodrum. Sounds like a lot of work to me. Sewing my Franken-paper. What is which crispy paper? Which one? That one? That is tracing paper. Or parchment paper. One or the other, which kind of basically the same. Where's my... Or like I said, tracing paper. But all tracing paper is not created equally. You knew you'd find me here. I had to work. I had to get out these papers. I haven't been on long. And once I'm done with these, I'll be headed off. It's going to be a very quick one. After this one, I have two left. But I have to get this done. This order has been a rough one for me. Not gonna lie to you. I guess just because I've been trying to, like, keep it all fitting in with the book cover, like the insert journal. So creating 8 pages that are different but the same, but different but the same, was kind of rough. Do you know what 8 of these pages. 8 of them. 8.
8.
Just in case, you know, because 8. And I don't keep repeating it for you guys. I keep repeating it for me. I don't know what the hell I was thinking. Uh-huh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2 less than 10. That's right. 4 more than 4. And it wasn't just this one either. I had another one before this where it was 6. So I had 2 orders like back to back that came in around the same time. One was for 6 Franken-papers and this one is for 8. Yes, it is too late for math, definitely. Amanda, you know, I definitely undercharged for these. This is reminding me of, number blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, number blocks. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I love my sewing machine. My sewing machine is my BFF. So yeah, so these papers, like, honestly, for one, I feel like it should be like $10. I'm not, like, just because it's a lot of work that I put into it. Because, right, all of these paper have some type of inking, splatters, the materials used. And then I glue it all together. And then I sew it. Hey, Lorraine, how are you? So, like that, and, like, that's hard for me to even say. Because that seems crazy. Like, $10 for, like, one piece of paper. But I probably put like 2 hours or so into like one paper. And I know that also sounds crazy, but like I just, I mean, look at it. Thank you. Thank you, Lorraine. Thank you. So yeah, so I really do try keeping like my prices reasonable when I do stuff like this. But I think with this one, this is definitely going to be, like, one of those luxury items. Because it takes a lot. Especially if you order, like, more than one. Like, this is a lot. Thank you, Wendy. Thank you. I appreciate that. I've had my machine since 2020, like January, February 2020. This thing has even traveled with me. Oh, that's another thing, right? So, like, these, the paper that I use for this, it's always, like, a mix of, like, cardstocks, vintage music note paper, Sometimes I have my 1950s dictionary pages in here. So it's a good mix of papers too. And if you, it's a lot of work. Actually, is it as easy as it looks? Did you ever try it again? I don't know who else tried it, but I know Ashley tried it. Wendy, did you try it? How was it for you, Wendy? So, Ashley, would you say anybody can do this? Anybody can do it. I want to try this with fabric. I mean, honestly, it is. Ashley, thank you. I do want to try this with fabric. Another name of this paper is like crazy quilt paper, I think is what they call it, because it's very similar to like doing a quilt with fabrics. But yep, there you go. Oh, thank you for that. You know what? That's a good idea. What the gray rock is cooking. I need somebody to take out my trash. So yeah, anybody can do this. It may take you a handful of times to get it to do it. And then you'll probably get it good. But yeah. It's not as easy as just gluing paper together. I will normally tell people, oh yeah, that's easy. You can do it. You can do it. But this one's a lot. This is a lot for me. It's a lot for me. Brooke, hi. I'm trying to figure out what I want to do with this one. Part of me wants to do a line, like line it like regular paper. The Franken-paper is a lot to make, especially if you're making like more than a couple at a time. So I kind of want to line it, but I don't know how it's going to look. You guys know what I mean by line? Just sew straight signatures across to give whoever's getting this writing space, like lines to write on. And I'm sure it looks beautiful, Wendy. Yes, if you don't have a sewing machine, you can do faux stitches with a marker. Alright, you know what? Let's do it. Let's do it. So you can use either, markers or a stamp. You can like go to Amazon, Temu, And they have line stamps, and you can use ink to make lines as well, like faux stitches. Sorry guys, I'm gonna try to be concentrating on this one, so. I think you're gonna loop stitch. Wendy, do I look like I know what loop stitching is? I don't know anything about sewing. I just know I can sew on paper and it looks pretty. Yeah, I'm liking this one too. That's gonna look pretty cool. Oh no. I'm gonna time, I'm not gonna time this one, but the next one, I'm gonna time it. Because I'm just curious. To know how long it takes. Okay. It is a CS, C as in cat, S as in Sam, 6600I, as in ice. If you guys see anything that I like, I do have an Amazon. If you guys see anything that I'm using, I do have an Amazon storefront. I think the link is on my link tree in my bio. Thank you. My link tree. My link tree that has like all my links. You know, YouTube, Facebook, Coffee, Etsy, my Amazon storefront. Oh, I thought you said what? Look, I can't see my screen for some reason. Like, I can see it, but the words are looking very, very dim for me. And I swear I thought you said what's in your bio. Thank you, Ashley. Oh, goodness. I need to go to the eye doctor, guys. I've been putting it off for a while. I really need to go. Remember what I told you earlier? If you're going to be like me and put your hand in there as you're sewing, be careful. I'm lucky I still have my finger. Fuck, that hurt. Trim it up. That's gonna be cool. 5 minutes and 37 seconds. Did you even start it? It started after, right? My finger hurts. And I did stop to do some music. So we're gonna have to get a new time. Okay. Well, as soon as you hear the machine, you can start timing it. Thank you, Wendy. I don't know why I'm putting this up. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna get started. Ready, set, go! money and power, minute after minute, hour after hour. Don't stop the timer because it's part of it. Okay, done. Anisha, I am sewing Franken-paper. Oh, Wendy. do those, they feel like I'm taking forever. It really does feel like I'm taking forever to do those. Hey, Rusty, how are you? And that's just the sewing part. That's not even all the other part that goes with it. I'm sorry, honey. I still have oil on the bottom of my machine from when I cleaned it and oiled it. So I have to make sure I clean after every round right now. Oh no. Ugh. I'm sorry. I hope he feels better soon. I did. Oh God. Oh no. Cool bath. Not a cold bath. Not even really a cool, but like a lukewarm bath just to like bring that temperature down, if anything, if nothing else works. I did hear from Jody. She was doing okay. They told her to keep an eye on it. And if it gets like any worse, she was going to go to the ER. So she still doesn't know exactly what happened. Gosh. So you guys can get a good look at my paper. Thank you, Rusty. Rusty, get the sewing machine. I say get the sewing machine. So for this journal, here's the cover. Let me grab it. It's 246. So this is the cover for this one. So now you guys see why I did all the colors and stuff that I did. And she wanted some coffee dyed paper. But with lines on it. And my printer was just like not really... It's not so bad. My printer was not loving printing on coffee dyed paper. Like I got a couple of good sheets, but that's it. Can you put it at the kitchen table? There you go. You could do that too. These will have to get trimmed down. Good night, Ashley. I'm trying to get these to look, like, to see how they look together. And then I'll be headed off to... Inside me say, I really don't think I'm strong enough now. So the two Franken pages, each signature is going to have two Franken pages. It's going to be the front and the back, the cover and the middle part of the book or the signature. Thank you, Ashley, for being here. I'm really confident, strong enough now. Don't pay attention to stuff like that, because this has to get trimmed. You froze. Yes, so the insert journal comes with two signatures, 8 pages each. So it's 16 pages. And the thing is that she bought two extra of these, right? So it holds two at a time. So she got the one that came with the book. But then she ordered an extra one as well. For once she's done with the first one, she could have a second one. Oh, God. I love these. Actually, oh, this is looking good. Okay. I was so worried about this. In my head, I was like, it's not gonna look good. It's gonna look like it's not working. Like, I just... But I'm okay with it. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's this. Some of these here. The mica spray and the distress oxide sprays are really, really fun. That's what I use to make like all of these splatters. And the shimmeriness of it. So this will be sewn together, but I like to put it in here first. And then I'll sew it together because I have to trim and all of that stuff. Yeah. breathe. I was so worried about this one. And it's definitely come together. Yes, they are definitely better now. Thank goodness. I won't have to tell anyone to leave because I can't breathe. Yeah. It's got to get trimmed, clearly. Everything will get trimmed except for the Franken-paper. The Franken-paper will be sticking out a little bit. Wendy. All right. You guys want to do a flip through? Let's do a quick little flip through. See how it all looks together. I do. I have to trim it down. I have to. The coffee dyed papers, I have to trim. Because you see some of them are like on the side. They get a little bit funky. Because coffee dyeing paper is hard. So good. I was so worried about this. You guys don't, I'm telling you, it's been like, I've been sitting on this. I've been sitting on this, finishing this for a little while now because I was so worried, but I like it. Oh, goodness gracious. Thank goodness that's coming out okay. It's a nightmare, Wendy. You want it? Yes, you have to be very, very careful. Thank you, Brooke. Yeah, when you're coffee dyeing paper, you have to be really, really careful whenever it's saturated with the coffee or dye or whatever it is that you're going to be working with, whatever liquid. Because once it's like fully saturated, the paper tears like so easily. It's awful. All right, ladies and gents, while I'm here, is anyone interested in any journals? Anybody want to buy any mini journals? Anybody want to buy a It's hard. Like it is hard. It's so hard. So hard. You guys. Oh. Wendy, remember I was looking for fabric? Remember I was looking for fabric? So I don't know if I'm going to use it for my specific journal that I had in mind, but no, wait, no, what? No, what? Yeah, so I don't know if I want to use it for what I had in mind, but I will be using this one for something because I do really, really like it. You don't like it, Wendy? It's beautiful.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's not what I had in mind either, but I still wanted it. Because, you know, I can make it work. I can make it work for other things as well. So, the lady, she sent me that. And that's a huge, like, it's a huge piece of fabric. Right? It's really, really big. So, she sent me some happy mail. And I need to send her some stuff back. So, she sent me these little things. She sent me some studs. And some of these cool little things. And I got some bling. And I got some happy mail from Cajun Nana. She sent me some fun stuff. Look, she sent me a glue. Topper and some pretty beads. You guys know I'm gonna use the crap out of this for my dangles and stuff. That's gonna be so fun. So this is a glue pin. So that goes like that. And she gave me some of the wax. And she gave me some of this fun stuff. This feels really cool. Oh, yeah. You don't like to read. Okay. And then she gave me some fun little envelopes. And she gave me a vintage check. From 1981. Is this a check? Maybe? Or a receipt? And I do believe this is a library card. And we have some fun big tags. And oh, I think this is French. Maybe? Or Spanish. That's because you live all the way over there, Wendy. You live all the way over there. So she gave me some little vintage book papers. You guys know I love my little vintage book papers. To be honest, normally I don't get a lot of happy mail. This wasn't a swap. Cajun Nana just sent this to me from the goodness of her heart. Because she wanted me to try this wax. She wrote me a really cute little note too. I really appreciated the note. I saw a great thing yesterday using a wax to make vellum. I never say no to happy mail. But you guys, I feel bad if you guys send me happy mail because okay, here's the deal, right? If you guys want to send me happy mail, let me pay for the shipping from my end. And I can email you the shipping label and you guys can just print it out. That way I can get like the better deal. Because if you guys go over there and ship it out, it'll probably be a lot. But the way I ship, it'll be more economical. Yep. I'm gonna have to ask. I'll ask my boyfriend to help me. You won't pay. What, Rusty? Ooh, girl. Well, if that's the case, go head on.
I never say no to Happy Mail. Never, ever, ever. We never, ever, ever say no to Happy Mail. No to Happy Mail. Sorry. I need to use my cuticle cutter real quick because my cuticles are bothering me. In order, it's in order. Which one? The teeny, teeny, tiny one? The pink one? This one. Yeah. She's a simple one. She's just a writing journal. When did I make her? I didn't make her too long ago. And she has a really good mix of the smallest one. I guess those would be the mini ones right now. The mini leather ones. Because I think those are even smaller than the first one that I did. You fill it in one day with your dreams? There's actually a good amount of writing space in there. I'll show you guys in a second. Just hold on. The first book I ever made was like 2x3 or 2.5x3, something like that. I have that posted on my TikTok too. I think I have it labeled as like my first book or something like that. My first book was made at the beginning of this year. It was a mini. Just like I tell anyone who's starting out to start with a mini and start with things that they don't really love. That's exactly how I started off. She was fat. I think she had like 3 or 4 signatures and I had a lot of paper in her. There was like no embellishing because it was my first book. I in my mind, I wanted to do the signatures, right? Because the sewing in, I guess the construction and the sewing was in my mind going to be the hardest part, right? So I was like, you know what? Like, I need to do it. Just so that I can get a feel for it to understand, you know, how it was gonna go. I created mine from a tomato paste box and fabric, and I cut down a shit ton of paper. I cut down way too much paper for that journal, to be honest. Like, I still have some of that paper cut down now. It's in my, she was fat. It's in my scrap box right now, the papers that I had for it. I did give the book away. I gave it to a friend of mine in real life. So yeah. And then the rest was history. Yeah, I miss your talking thing. I just freaked it up. Okay, so here we go. I'm gonna show you what the inside is look like. So it's 3 signatures. I don't remember how many papers. But you see,
Like, there's a good amount of writing space. Wendy, are you asking me to scream at somebody? No, we scream. Oh, there's a little pocket. Look at that. I made a little pocket. I didn't even know I did that, honestly.
You miss my talking thingy? What talking thingy? I don't know. Look. Happy day? Talking thingy. A talking thingy. Oh, where is it? Is it not? Are you talking about the auto captions? I don't know where it is. I don't know how to turn it on. I'm sorry. I think you have to turn it on, right? It's captions. It's what Rusty said. So yeah, just different pages. So lots of writing space in this little one if you want to write. Did everyone see this one? It's already sold. Can't buy it. But I can make other ones pretty much just like it. I made that one this morning. It's leather. Nah, it's not a necklace. It's just a piece of chain. I mean, it's chain that would be used as a necklace, right? But it's just a chain here. But you can put charms on it. So the way it closes, I added two jump rings because the lobster hook won't connect through these. It took almost 8 hours. I mean, technically, yeah, I was on live today for this morning for 7 hours and 38 minutes. This would not take me typically 7 hours to do. It took me that long because I was on live and I was enjoying it and having fun. I did sewing, a good amount of sewing. My webbed coffee-dyed paper. It did come out cool, Eric. I'm so glad. I'm so glad Eric said spider web. Because, like, the spider web definitely just took off. How fun that paper is. Oh, God. Alright. After I'm showing this, I need to go. I need to get out of here. The paper, honestly, they have Franken-paper. But it's really just different coffee-dyed paper. And a good amount of sewing, cardstock, the Franken-paper again, Franken-paper in the back, and then, so the leather, you know, it's a little bit soft, so I had to stabilize it. So this is watercolor paper that I stamped on, and it's glued down to the leather, and this is cardstock to make a little pocket. But yeah, I can definitely make more of these if anybody's interested. It's 3 signatures. I forgot how many pages at this point. Good night. Good night. Okay, anybody have any questions? Anybody have any questions? I'm going to start working on... Eric, your mini journal order. I'm going to start working on it either tomorrow or Wednesday. Just so that, you know, you're aware. I have a couple of other ones that I need to do too. Yay, more minis. I kind of needed to take a break from the minis. I did. I needed to take a break from the minis. I needed to take a break from a few things. Okay. Good night, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. I appreciate it. If you have any questions, you want to make a custom order, thank you, Eric. I appreciate it. Brooke, I still have to contact you. I have this... I'm going to be getting out a custom order in the next couple of days. I just want to finish that before I do anything else. And actually, probably 2 of them. I need to finish the Japanese book and this one that I was making the Franken-paper for. And then I'll probably contact you if you're still interested in doing the custom order. Okay. Okay. Okay, perfect. Sounds good. Sounds good. All right, and once again, if you guys have any questions, you can DM me. All my links are in my link tree in my bio. I appreciate you taking a look. And have a good night. Bye. Bye, Wendy. Finger hearts.